Peter Bevan is on the Regional Council and he's the chair of Hawke's Bay's Coastal Hazards Joint Committee. I spoke to him just before we came on air and asked him if the residents of Clifton Road can afford to stay there.
Well, it's up to the local communities to actually decide what the strategy has to be. You know, this is not the first time those houses have been hit with waves. It probably happens every 2 or 3 years. So there are risks living there. There are long-term risks, of course, and eventually they may have to move, but it's up to the community appetite for risk as to determine what the strategy is for those people, how they defend themselves, whether they have to move. And you have to bear in mind that the National Policy Statement on the coast requires us to develop a 100-year strategy.
Okay, if they have to move, what form of compensation do they receive?
Well, that's entirely up to the councils and them to discuss and decide. And we've got no guidance from the government on what that might look like. We don't even know whether the government will participate in this. And I can sort of understand why the government is reticent to get involved, because when you look around New Zealand and you see the number of coastal communities that might be at risk in the future with sea level rise, it's a big problem for us as a country.
It's a really big problem, and this represents the universal and the particular, doesn't it, this community? So is it time the government started being proactive and initiating conversations with organisations like yours, communities like Haumoana, where people may have to leave and will not be able to sell their properties?
Well, I'd certainly like to see the government take a much more proactive role than they have so far. They have funded some research into this area, but they certainly haven't, at this point in time, made any commitment to do more than that. And it's a hole that the local councils, the local authorities, are having to fill. And it's a difficult one, because without national guidance, we'll all go and do different things. And there needs to be a commonality as to how we approach these issues.
Right, so you want some leadership from the government here?
Oh, absolutely, I think we need it.
And do you need money from the government?
That's got to be part of the conversation.
Okay, what work has the council been doing in the meantime, separate from what the government may or may not do to mitigate erosion along that coastline?
All right, so what we're currently involved in here is all three councils, Hastings, Napier and the regional council, working together as a joint committee, and we've formed the Hawke's Bay into two cells, from the Napier Port North and from Napier Port South, and we've drawn people from all of the communities along those coastlines to form a panel who are currently considering what the options are and what their preferences are, and that work will be finished and recommendations made to the councils before the end of this year. So we've actually been quite proactive, I think.
There are parts of that coastline where 2 metres of road has been lost in roughly a week. Are you worried about this? Can you afford to deal with this?
Yeah, that's a very good question. And in fact, in my lifetime, that road has been reformed a couple of times and it's actually been moved back probably 40 or 50 metres.
So does it have to go back again?
Well, it certainly will have to be moved back again because it's undercut quite badly. The problem is that there is a camping ground there and there's a boat ramp and people want to preserve those things. You know, the first instinct of any person or community along the coastline is to preserve what they've got. They want to defend it.
Absolutely. And Peter, I was just talking to you 2 minutes ago about the fact that compensation will be required. Surely, if people are going to have to walk away from the land because the sea is eating the coast, and you have no money and you have no direction from the government.
Oh, and that's quite simply our problem. When you compare us with a country like Holland, for instance, that's got about, 250 or 300 kilometres of coast and 20 million people to fund their defence, the solutions in New Zealand aren't going to look like the solutions in Holland. So we have to be realistic about what we can afford, but we also have to take into account what the local communities want and what their appetite for risk is. So,
and also, do you have to be more hard-nosed about people who are looking, for example, to put subdivisions along the coast, build close to the coast? Do you have to be much more proactive in explicitly identifying risk?
Oh, absolutely. That's got to be a function of council for future housing developments. They have to take a precautionary approach, I guess, because they'll only run into problems further down the track. So absolutely, yes, councils have got to be mindful of the uncertainties of sea level rise, because at the moment we're working on a sea level rise of anything up to 1.5 metres in the next 100 years. But, you know, some scientists are saying that that's an underestimate. It might be 3 metres, and that changes the game. So whatever strategy we develop, it has to be an adaptive one, so that if there are trigger events that happen sooner than we think or that we're currently anticipating, then the people are ready for it.